Sometimes the atmosphere takes center stage, sometimes it's the actors. In the case of The Beguiled, it is a perfect storm of both, and a retelling of Clint Eastwood's 1971 Beguiled. You have the Civil War, a Southern girls' boarding school, and a wounded Union soldier to create an unexpected turn of events.
We ask for your protection over our school, and we pray that we will be kept from harm throughout the night.
I saw the first Beguiled.
Oh, yeah.
Oh, yes. And it has stayed with me forever.
Oh, really?
And this movie is too. Why did you decide to give us a new spin on a most beguiling tale?
A friend of mine told me, you have to see this film, The Beguiled. I'd never heard of it. And of course, people that really know film know it. And she said, I think you need to make a new version, your version of it. And I thought, oh, I would never remake someone else's film. But when I saw it, it just stayed in my mind. And it was so, haunting. I couldn't get out of my mind. And the story of these Southern women at a girls' school bringing in an enemy soldier during the Civil War. And the premise is so loaded and full of sexual tension. The turn in it was so surprising to me. So I thought, oh, it'd be so interesting to tell the same story, but from the female character's point of view. And that's what got me interested in it. And I found the book that it was based on. And
Martha! Miss Martha!
Is he dead?
No. Get him inside. Quick! You're our most unwelcome visitor, and we do not propose to entertain you.
You'll find I'm easily amused.
You won't be here long enough for that.
How did you end up in this place?
Why are you so interested in me?
I admire your strength.
I'm just trying to give them what they need to survive in these times.
If you could have anything in the world, what would it be?
To be taken far away from here.
Come with me.
Of course, having Colin Farrell as an enemy isn't so bad. Is it?
No. But still, like, trying to be a Christian woman and an example for the girls, and then on the other hand, having all these feelings bubbling up that, you know, obviously there's a lot of repression for Edwina, and so she's at that age where she should be, you know, having suitors, and she comes from the city, and she, I feel bad for Edwina.
Aww.
The whole idea of women and this undercurrent is what's so beguiling about this movie.
It is. And it was great. Also, we got to, and Colin was such a good sport with us too, because we really reversed the role of kind of how women are sometimes portrayed in films of being kind of, you know, oh, she comes in, she's the object. And in this film, we made the man the object. And I remember one day, it was kind of like a day of Colin like gardening, and he had like his top off, and all of like Sophia, all the girls we were around, like kind of like giggling at him. It was like a sexy calendar shoot day for Colin. He was like had the hose and he was like digging, and we were laughing, because I don't know, in other films they would make the woman, the really, oh,
the
overly
object,
sexy.
Object of desire,
so
yes.
So we got to switch that up with our film.
Look for The Beguiled, a spellbinding, seductive thriller in your real-time theater.